Welcome everyone to this talk by Alexander Wirth. He will give us an update about the Debian list servers and how to distribute all the messages to 100,000 people. Give him a round of applause, please.
Yeah, hello. It's nice to be here. In fact, this is my first talk in English, so I will hope that it works. So this is the famous List Master talk. We want to tell you some things about how we are doing lists, what we did during DevConf, and what we plan for the future. Who am I? My name is Alexander Wirth. I'm a Debian developer since 2003. I'm a List Master. I'm an LDAF admin. I do maintain a few packages, one about 40 packages, like IPRoot, Ethinger, Nagios, and some other stuff. If I don't do open source, I got paid by Creditive, where I'm a senior consultant, and I do help other people to implement open source solutions. But back to ListMaster. We are a team. We have some members. At least two of them are here in the auditorium. That's Martin Zubel-Hillers, Kurt Behrmann, Don Armstrong, who is also doing BugsDebian.org. Yeah, that's me. And the not so active ones are Martin Joey Schulze and Pascal Hakim. The last two haven't been seen for a long time. So there's a reason they are in italic. What are we doing? ListDebian.org is run by SmartMail and PostFix. For everyone who's not familiar with SmartMail, SmartMail is a list manager from the last century based on procmail. So it's basically just a gigantic set of procmail rules. I would say a few thousand rules. Yeah. Sure, it's smart list, of course. We only see them as procmail. We also do bug subscriber management. So if you subscribe to a bug, this is also going to ListDebian.org and is managed by enemies of Carlotta, which is also subject to get replaced in the future because enemies of Carlotta is out of maintenance for some time now. And in fact, it's never finished. So we are dealing with a bunch of bugs in it. We also do complaint and abuse management. There are always people that are surprised that posting to a public mailing list gets you on a web visible archive. And so we usually have to deal with such people. There are also people that don't behave like they should behave on a mailing list. There's also this last part about childcare. Especially in the last year with the systemd flame wars, life wasn't that nice on lists. I don't know if anybody of you reads Debian User or Debian User German. We had to do things to get back to normal, like banning people, warning people, and so on. So that's also part of the things we are doing. We also maintain the list archive. So if you want to read older mails from the lists on the web, this is done by our list archive, which is run by Monarch, which is also a software of the last century. There aren't any good replacements yet. Some numbers. We are dealing with mails, a lot of mails. In 1 month, we had distributed around about 34,000 mails to our users, where we have 100,000 unique subscribers. This makes up delivering 16 million mails a month, which is not that bad. On the other side, we do reject 390,000 mails during SMTP time. We have a bunch of advanced post-fix rules that try to get out the usual spammers. If mails make it to our SMTP server, they went to SpamAssess and Amavis, which removes another 51,000 mails. And we also have procmail rules, which remove spam and other broken mails, which give us another 65,000 mails. That means we're protecting you from more than 500,000 mails a month, just with our spam rules. That is, for such a lot of lists and a lot of languages, a really good number, I think. On the other side, we, as list masters, get around about 15,000 mails a month, which we have to deal with, like complaints, abuse, questions, bugs, and so on. Yeah, misguided subscribe or unsubscribe requests. It's surprising how hard it is to unsubscribe from a list. We had some list master sprints during this DevConf, where we implemented, fixed, and did other things with lists. We also have some numbers and stuff. We managed it to close 100 bugs in our list Debian org package. This is a really good number. We updated lists Debian org alias Bendel to Jesse. We updated Monarch, which is also a big task because our Monarch is heavily patched. We enhanced our list pages with statistic and a direct inline search. This goes in hand with our improvement of the list search. List search was broken for 1.5 years now. Thankfully, nobody cared about it. But however, it works again. And you are now able to do much more improved searching in mailing lists now. So you can search explicitly for specific lists, specific dates, and other stuff. We have to give a big thank to Oddy for this, which was one of the Xapian upstream developers who really helped us in improving that. In fact, he did all the work. We also improved our DKIM handling. I guess most people aren't familiar with the subject DKIM. It's derived from Yahoo domain keys, and it's a method to sign headers in an email with a public key, which enables receiving mailers to verify that this mail is really coming from Yahoo or Google or something like that. Problem with DKIM is, in the past, we added footers under our mails with unsubscription links, with archive links, and such stuff. And this modifies the mail. This has a consequence that if the mail was signed before, the signature is invalid afterwards. And if we distribute the mail to a mailer that honors DKIM, it will reject the mail because it's not a valid mail from Google anymore or from Yahoo. And that leads to problems. Therefore, we removed every footer, in general, every body modification we had before in list-db.org. So some of you maybe already noticed that the footer is gone. In days with MIME, most people haven't seen the footer most of the time because it's just lost somewhere in the MIME tree. We moved all those informations into the header. So if you are looking for an archive link or an unsubscription link, look into the header of a mail. We are also following the relevant RFC at that point. So there are also some mailers that present you buttons for unsubscribing or list joining. There's an extension for Thunderbird, for example. We also created some new lists and closed some duplicated lists. What's still on our list? Unfortunately, time is limited and we weren't able to do everything we wanted to do. So what's left? In the future, we want to also honor DKIM at our SMTP server, which means if Google says, Yahoo is the only one that does that. They said, if you receive a mail from yahoo.com, which has an invalid DKIM signature, reject the mail. This is commonly known as P is reject. That's coded into some DNS header, DNS text entry. We want to do this in the future. We have a spam review system, more on that later, that we want to integrate with some single sign-on. Especially, we want to get array of users into the spam review system. We had a Google Summer of Code project in the last year, which produced some maybe Monarch replacement called plist, which we have to evaluate to see if it fits our needs in every case or to improve it, and maybe get replace Monarch. Some of our mailing lists do signature checking on receiving mails. This is especially for those announced mailing lists like Debian Devil Announce, Debian Security. They do GPG checks on incoming mails, and our check is not very sophisticated and is always failing on some of my mails that needs to get improved. Because inline signatures with GPG is not really the method you are using today. This list depconf.org. 2 years ago, the depconf team decided we wanted to move this depconf.org into this debian.org infrastructure. That should be done. There are some political reasons that isn't done yet. But we hope to get this done, maybe up to Cape Town. Yes, it's not the list master problem, it's a political problem inside the DepConf organization. Some of our mailing lists are moderated. The methods how this moderation works is very special. We should really get something better, like a web front end, or even a good mail front end at this point, be it to improve high volume mailing lists like Debian user with some moderation. That is currently not possible yet. In the last year, I have written some ban manager to cope up with those bans, to implement things like timed bans and commands and a web overview, who is banned, why he's banned, and so on. We need to integrate that at Tuno. Comes to my next topic. We need help. We need a lot of help. So, if you like mail, Postfix, maybe even XSIM, there are better things to learn. If you're able to deal with strange old software like SmartList, Procmail, Shell scripts, and if you're interested in being a list master, please get in touch with us. We really need help. If you're not able to answer all those questions with yes, there are some isolated tasks you maybe help us with. That's the part with the SigCheck tool, as I said. It's currently written in Python, which is not the language which is spoken from the active list masters. So we need help. Either improve it or rewrite it in Perl. That's also fine. Back to the plist I talked about. It's template driven, and the templates are currently very basic. So we would need some web guy who's willing to do this with some HTML and some CSS to get a proper looking web archive ready for the year 2015, which is currently not the case with the Monarch setup. Yeah, that's the other one, the spam review front end should work with an Elliott front end. At the current point, we only allow Debian developers to do the spam review. And we want to get more help there. Just a little bit to the techniques. On every list archive page, there is a button where you can report spam. And if the relevant number of people report a mail as spam, gets into a review process. And we urge active DDs or later area of users to review such reports to decide if this is really spam. And if it's really spam, we remove it from the archive. That's the point where we need help. That can do everybody who's able to read a mail. And if you are able to read Korean mail, Japanese mail, or something like that, you get bonus points because that are things that are not that far distributed. Yeah, that's basically from my side. Now, do you have any questions or feedback to the Listmaster team? Now is your chance to tell us something.
I have a question about more statistics. How many people are banned and how many ban requests do you get per month or whatever?
That's hard to say. Not everyone is banned on every list and not everyone is banned with every subject. There are some more or less complicated procmail rules to decide who's banned. I would say at the current point, maybe 40 or 50 people at Zoom. Yeah, there are some spammers, and it's hard to differentiate between those mail addresses we block for spamming or we block for other reasons. Let's say just for behavior, we have maybe 10 to 20 people.
You mentioned the DKIM for signatures for the domains, and I'm interested if you want to check other mails arriving into the system. And if they want us to reject the system we reject, or you want to tell others if they are without signature from the Debian domain, it should be rejected.
No, we won't sign outgoing mails because that gets us into other problems. Mm-hmm. I talked to some DKIM experts. They told me, that would lead to DKIM stapling, being a mail signed with several signatures, which is in theory possible, but no one is doing that yet. And they are not sure what will happen. So we decided on not signing our mails outgoing.
Any other questions? We still have a minute or two.
I can only support Alex on that we really, really, really need help in the Listmaster team because I need to admit that I'm more or less inactive and just jumping in if help is really urgently needed. Otherwise, I'm mostly busy with my DSA stuff. So anyone who has spare time and likes to read Listmaster mail, come speak with us and see what you can do.
How much spare time are we talking about?
It would be possible to get a full-time job out of it, but if you have spare time, we will be happy to use it. So if you were able to invest maybe half an hour a day or an hour a day, or every second day, that would be great.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah, reading such a lot of mails is usually really time needing. But if you have not that much time, we will still be able to use it.
Okay. Any other final question? No? Thank you, Alexander. Thank you again.